Race plays a lot in who you are. It really gives you a sense of identity. And I feel that growing up, we struggle with that, you know? And in high school, I realized who I was because I did become more in tune with my race.
I was born in Monterrey, Mexico, and I was born and raised there. I grew up all my life there. All my family is back there. And I lived there for 14 years of my life.
I was born in Bronzeville, Texas. It's 5 minutes away from the Mexican border. So the Mexican culture has always been a very heavy aspect in my life, especially because both my parents were born in Mexico. My dad is from Mexico City, and his whole family is still living over there. Many did move to the United States for a better future.
So I'm from Houston, Texas. My mother was actually born here in Houston as well. My father was actually born in Matamoros, Tamaulipas.
I was born and raised here in Texas. My mother was also born here in Texas, but her parents are from Mexico, and my father is from Mexico as well. He immigrated over here at a young age. He never actually finished his high school degree or the equivalent to his high school degree because he needed to move to find work so that way he can better his life and better his family's life.
I was born in San Antonio, Texas. My family has always lived in San Antonio ever since it was a Mexican colony, and they stayed there when it became a part of the United States.
I was actually born in Cali, Colombia. My family and I migrated into the United States in 2001 in search for a better future.
Both of my parents were born in Ponce, Puerto Rico. I was born in Connecticut and immediately moved to Puerto Rico to live with my family due to the situation. After the riots and poverty kicked in, we moved to the United States for a better job.
So I was born in Baytown, Texas. So were my parents. And I do have a few grandparents and other family members that did come over to America from Mexico. It's very hard for them to talk about their journey because they tend to get very emotional. And it's something that I feel that they try to suppress from their memory because it wasn't easy coming over here.
Mira lo que hace, mira lo que va. These are the best and the finest. When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're not sending you. They're not sending you. They're sending people that have lots of problems, and they're bringing those problems with us. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists. And some, I assume, are good people.
If we clean up the mess, we don't even know. You said 11 million. Nobody knows what the numbers are. They're going out, and they're coming back in legally. That's the way it has to be. Number one, I'm building a wall. They're not coming in anymore. Mexico is paying for the wall. We're building the wall. It's going to be a serious wall. It's going to be a real wall. It's not going to be a wall that they just climb up and you see what they do.
We need to build a wall. And it has to be built quick. We have no choice.
Well, Steve,